Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to set up C in Visual Studio Code. So first I will be showing you how to download and install mingw, which is a C compiler, and later I will be showing you how to install Visual Studio Code and finally get the required extensions and also to run your first C program. So let's get started. First just Google mingw and we'll be having the link from sourceforge.net. Click it and here we will be having the mingw for Windows. So just click on download and the download will be getting started. It's just a setup file, 84 KB in size. So just click it and click on install. So that is going to be the installation directory. If you want to change it, you can change it. Just click on continue. And this will take some time to download, just be patient. So once all the necessary things have been downloaded, you can just click on continue. And here we will be having the list of compilers that we need to install. So just click it and select mark for installation. So by this way we are checking that. So just do the same for everything except Fortran. So just do the same for all. Once you are done checking the necessary stuff, to the leftmost top we'll be having the installation. Select it and click on apply changes and just click on apply. So again this will download the necessary packages. Just be patient, and once everything is installed we'll be getting this all changes were applied successfully. You may now close this dialog. So just click on close. And we can also close the mingw installation manager. So now we need to add the mingw installation location in our environment variable. So to quickly find that, just go to search and type mingw and we'll be having this mingw installation manager. We can just click on open file location and this will take us to this folder. Here also right click and select open file location again. So this will directly take us to the folder where mingw has been installed. So it's in our local disk C mingw folder. Go to that main folder of mingw and click on bin. So we need to copy this particular path. Place your mouse on top and click on copy address. Now again go to search and type environment. We will be having the edit the system environment variables. Select that and go to environment variables. And here under system variables, we need to select path. So scroll down, select path and edit. Here, go to the top and click on new and just paste this path. And click on OK. Click on OK everywhere. Now go to search and open command prompt and open it. So now here we will be running the command, which is g++ space hyphen hyphen version. So after running that, also run gcc space hyphen hyphen version and hit enter. So we'll be getting the gcc version also, which is basically the same one. And in case if you are getting some error, which means that you haven't added the right path in the environment variable, make sure that you are checking that. So now let's go and install Visual Studio Code. The first thing, just Google Visual Studio Code and you'll be getting the first link from code.visualstudiocode.com. Just click that and here you'll be having option for download for Windows, and if you want to read it you can just scroll and read it. Just click it and the download will be getting started, and it is about 100 MB in size, the setup file. Just be patient till then. Once the download is complete, just double click and open it. You'll be getting the Visual Studio Code setup. Just click on I accept the agreement. If you want you can read it. Just click on next. This is going to be the location. I'll just leave it to default. Click on next. This is fine. Next. And make sure that you are checking everything over here like this. Yeah, this is good. And click on next and just click on install. So just be patient. Yeah, once the installation is complete, you will be having the launch Visual Studio Code. Just check that and click on finish. and you'll be getting the Visual Studio Code interface open like this. So now let's just create a new folder for our C project. So go to File, Open Folder, and just go to your desired location. Here you can create a new folder. Right click and click on New Folder. Just name it whatever you want. Let me go with C Programs and select that folder. Now that particular folder will be getting opened in our Visual Studio Code. You can just click Yes, I trust the authors. So this folder has no files inside it, and just click on this new file option to create a file. Just name your file. Let me go with C program, and you need to have the .c extension. And if you create a C program, automatically to the rightmost bottom you will be having, do you want to install the recommended C or C++ extension pack? So you can just click on install for it. And this will install this particular extension pack. Just be patient. So this extension pack helps with auto recommendation and intelligence and makes our coding way easier. And now in the extensions search for code runner. This extension makes our running the program simple. Rather than using the terminal or commands, we can run our C program by a click of a button. So now to change the font size, you can just click on the settings icon to the left and click on settings option. And here we will be having the font size. You can just change the whatever value you want. I would recommend you to select a number between 30 or 50. That's totally up to you. Let me just begin with a simple C program. And as you saw that, right, each time when I type a code, it gets auto recommended. So the coding is going to be so simple. So this is my basic C program, and I'll be showing you two ways how you can run this. One is by using the terminal command, and next one is with the help of the code runner extension that we have installed. So now we need to open the terminal. So you can just right click on that program name and select open in integrated terminal. And here you will be running the command gcc space your file name with the extension. So it's going to be cprogram.c, and it gets compiled. It will create a a.exe file. Now we need to view the output of that file. So for that, you need to run the command /a. So this helps us to view the output, and hit enter. As you can see, hello viewers is getting printed. And now the second way is going to be simple. To the rightmost top, you'll be having this debug run icon, right? Click on that drop down and select run code. And this will also give you the output in the terminal. As you can see, this command gets executed and we are getting the result. So this is just a shortcut way how to run the code. That's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.